Alright, this is gonna be my first ESA submission. My name is Magic, the game is Bedlam, and I'm gonna play the new game. Time won't start just yet. Time will start as soon as I gain control over the character.
You should probably try not to move too much, otherwise the lasers might sever your spine, but that hardly ever happens, so don't sweat it. Nah, seriously lady, just close your eyes and chill.
So I'm gonna do this separate video, even though I have some that also have commentary in it,
otherwise,
just because I thought it might be better to explain some of the stuff going on, because the other videos were just taken from my streams, where I don't always explain everything. So, anything noticeable at this point is just, this is an FPS game. And I'm jumping, because that is slightly faster than not jumping. We will get to hear some of the story, but more segments than something you can really understand stuff from. Right here we have a little tutorial, which is pretty basic. You can crouch, you can jump over stuff, you can take damage, you can jump over more stuff, you can jump through those. Here's the only thing maybe interesting, you can, by pressing E, move those crates. You could also move barrels, for example. You won't see that a lot in the speedrun. A little fun fact right here, even though our character doesn't know it yet, this is just a mirror image and copies our movement, except crouching. No idea why. Sorry here, you experienced something that we will see a couple of times. The run. There's a lot of dialogue that cannot be skipped, that cannot even be sped up. So we'll have to wait for it. I usually use this to talk about some general stuff. So maybe, what is this game even about? This game is just. Well, we saw the intro cutscene. Where we were kind of scanned, but we don't really know much at this point, and so does our character. Her name is Heather Quinn, aka Athena. I don't even want to say too much about the story at this point. We will hear some segments of the story. So we just got our first weapon, which is pretty strong for a first weapon in my opinion. At least on easy, it can, even in the late game, one hit a lot of enemies. This is also kinda how balancing or the increasing of difficulty in this game works. Enemies won't get too much stronger later, but especially in the mid game, you just get weapons that are way worse. So what we just saw on the left right there was a glitch. You're expected to go there for the first time, but why didn't he die? I don't get this. I still don't get this sometimes. You're supposed to enter this glitch. Because Athena is like, well, maybe that's the way I can get out. But it's not. The only thing you get is a weapon that you won't see in the game. Oh, maybe I pick it up if I mess up my pathing at one point, but it's never gonna be used. So right here there's gonna be, again, some unskippable dialogue, so I'm just gonna use the time to pick up some supplies. There's the shotgun right here, as well as some HP, and up there is an armor.
Blood of the fathers! They're coming from all sides! We need...
Maybe worried about how weapons work. Every weapon can shoot, obviously, and some of them also have an alternative fire mode or just something on right click. Not everything though. Like our first weapon right here does not have anything special on right click, but the shotgun does. When you right click on shotgun, it would shoot two shots at the same time, dealing double the damage, of course, which is quite useful. This level can be a little messed up. Usually not a new game, but often a new game plus, because you're faster, and that, yeah, it can get unfortunate. So what you have to do is control all those three points at the same time. The point is, though, that the game doesn't constantly check which points you have and which not. It only checks for which points you have the moment you take over a point. So what can happen, especially in New Game Plus when you're going too fast, is when the enemies are taking back a point, like they do right now, and at this very moment I would capture this point right here, the game would check whether I completed the objective or not, and obviously I wouldn't have done this, but because I'm so fast, I would be able to still stop the enemies from completely retaking this point. And yeah, that confused us a couple of times, because at this point the game won't check again whether you completed the objective or not, so you kind of soft lock. What you have to do then is letting the enemies take back the point and then take it back yourself, but that obviously loses quite some time. I'm taking quite some damage right now. This is not really expected, but no problem either. The upside of those dialogue downtimes is I can chill a bit, and also I can get supplies just in the first level. Now I'm waiting here for a moment so the enemies right there won't hit me too much. And now I'm gonna get right here to the end of the level.
Okay, let's try something else.
Yeah, I'm doing pretty good right now. Haven't done this run in quite some time. So this is the first of two times we'll actually use this feature of stacking crates. I'm really happy that both of the times will be during downtime, so I don't have to hurry too much, because the controls are a little wonky regarding this.
We're in a game. I don't know how we got here. If there was a way in, there must be a way out.
So I've talked about weapons. What I haven't talked about yet are enemies. Enemies have aimbot. Straight away.
I can hear you.
They will always shoot directly at you, which is a problem with some weapons. They basically use the same weapons you can acquire as well. For example, this one I'm holding right now. You can dodge those shots if you're fast enough sometimes. Rocket launcher shots can also be dodged because they're very slow. But shotgun shots come in instantly. So if you don't manage to kill an enemy on time, run past him and he has a shotgun, that can hurt a lot. So in the beginning of the game it's actually kinda likely to die. Likely is too much said, but it might happen.
Save my boys from execution. You can start by taking out that homicidal tin can right there.
So story wise what happened, we kinda switched sides right now, because some other real person told us to get out of this game. And right now we're gonna face the first boss. What I'm gonna try and do is get behind him, because then you can't shoot at me. That's not a problem damage-wise, but it creates lag. Also, what I did was, as soon as the weapon was empty, I switched to the shotgun and back, and that skipped the reload animation. Now there's another downtime. I can collect some stuff, some HP, some ammo for this weapon, which is a... I'm not exactly sure if I said that already. It's the highest DPS weapon in the game. I think I didn't say it yet. I'm waiting here because I can pick it up another time to get some more ammo.
That is, unless you can take out the guard towers. You think you can handle that horse?
And now we can go towards the end of the level.
And I'm not sure I actually have teeth anymore, so, you know.
Outstanding! Take these explosives and let's show these rust buckets what the 4th of July really looks like.
I lost a little bit of time, but it's not a big issue. Let's hope I don't get too much lag here. I don't know why this happens. It can happen way more often than it just did. And it's not just me, it's for everyone. We have a rogue in the canyon. So what we're supposed to do here is destroying those towers. When I first played this game, I was a little disappointed of how this works, because all you do is press E at the spots. Every tower has two of those spots. There are three towers in total. Oh, I missed. There's a little bit of going around. Compared to New Game Plus, this level is really slow. Because, well, it's a canyon. You have to go up and down. While in New Game Plus, you can boost around everywhere. I still prefer this category. I don't really know why. Probably because it's also about ammo management and... Well, you do a lot more different stuff. So, two towers are gone. And pretty soon, we're gonna see the first thing in the run that I would like to call skip. That I dare to call skip. I hope I get it first time. It looks very easy, and it's not too hard. Not gonna lie about this. But it's not as easy as it looks. And I sometimes fail it, but I got it.
That is just fucking wrong.
Usually you're supposed to go around all the way. Which is slow, obviously. The jump looks really easy, but for one reason it's not. It's the controls become really wonky when you're up there.
We got them on the run. All companies, converge on the reactor.
Interesting.
Oh no, wait, that's not where I'm supposed to go.
What happened to the war?
Supposed to go up.
And what
oh, that's not
to
good.
The gravity?
Shouldn't be too much of an issue.
Where the hell did you go? Are you in the training arena?
So this is the first level that kind of shows where this game is going.
Grab yourself a rocket launcher, get
you
your
don't
ass
really
back here,
just stay in this world where you started. You get around a bit.
Okay,
so I want to pick up this rocket launcher right there. Not because I will need it in this level or to fight later on. I want it for skips. I will have to collect three rocket launchers in total to do all the skips I want. Right here it's just deathmatch against computer enemies, which can kill you pretty quickly. Basically they're just as strong as you are.
Owned in this place. Owned with a capital zero.
Wait, you're a girl? Get back to playing the
Luckily, it's no issue if you die. You just respawn. The goal here is to kill 15 enemies.
Where did you find this
and, it's RNG where they spawn.
That was lag. That was lag.
So you need to be a little bit lucky. Also, you might notice that there are little kids that are talking to me, which I thought was pretty funny when I first played this game. I'm gonna fall down.
I bet you rage quit like a champ.
slow, but not too much of an issue either. So when I first played this, I thought it was a funny idea, but when you speedrun this and hit us over and over again, it gets really annoying, I can tell you. The enemies we are facing here, by the way, are equipped with the four different weapons we can have at this time.
Okay, asshole, tell me where you got these hacks and maybe I won't report you. Oh my god, I am so bad in this dick.
It's not going too good, especially because the spawns aren't really perfect. Come on, give me the last one, real quick. Okay, you're gonna be the last one. And I'm also quite healthy. That's good. You wanna try and be healthy at this point. Because from now on, it will matter again if you die.
Then we can start using the Greylax old scary ass subspace power sources against them.
If you don't stop that coolant guy, traitor, then you'd better have your die trying.
This section, by the way, is pretty dangerous. The reason for that is you have really narrow passageways with a lot of enemies, and a lot of them also have shotguns, which is really bad. If you can't kill them quickly, they can deal a ton of damage to you.
Console goddess, if you're still up there, now would be a good time to give me god mode or infinite ammo or something.
Yeah, you saw that. That was so much damage. That was... they can deal a lot more, even. This part here can get annoying, depending on what those guys decide to do. Basically, you have to kill everything here in order to advance. And what they do, they try to follow you, but they're not particularly good at this. So they might end up anywhere. And they can also get stuck in the air. It's also not cool. I'm just gonna get the HP right here, because I really don't want to die right now. Would also be the marathon safety. You can pick up HP in a lot of situations here. So if you're playing it safe, you should survive. I wish I didn't say this. Oh god, I'm so low. Gonna take that HP right here as well. Well, I'm really taking unexpectedly much damage here. So this guy right now has a rocket launcher which you can dodge. Alright. Oh, that was really close. You can really die pretty quickly here. You're a little unlucky. A little fun fact here, Athena just said it's like impossible to stop the reactor. It is extremely easy even playing casually. But it's just a waste of time, so we don't do that.
Sterling, here I come. I'll never moan about the weather again.
This is another really good example of where this game's going. It's the first glitch that we see. Usually it would be the second. Second glitch world, let's say like this. And those glitch worlds, let's say they connect different worlds, different games. They are really open, which means that later on, as soon as we have the tools needed, we can skip a lot of those. But not at this point, unfortunately.
Can anybody hear me? Hello?
Do you read me? come in.
I read you. Hello?
Do you read me? Oh, shit.
Arse candles. Don't mind.
So we now are in a completely different world. And we can skip some stuff here. This is a wall you can get over using a rocket launcher. What you have to do here is get in a key to exit the level. Oh, I didn't kill him, that's not good, because you can then get stuck in him. Oh, also got stuck there. It's unfortunate to lose time there. That's pretty consistent level usually.
Any friendly so is this. Death or glory, get your ass out of there now. The integrity are locking that place down good. Closing the glitches and rerouting all the spawn points. Trust me, if you don't get out soon, you're never leaving.
This time we have to get even higher up. And get this nice little weapon.
It's no lie. I swear I've seen that.
It's gonna be used later on. And get over here as well. Saved some time here, but I think that was because I didn't know about one of the skips during my PB. So upcoming would be the next boss fight, but our rather new runner Torrent found a skip for this, because usually you have to fight this boss, because there's an invisible wall around him, but it ends before the building starts, so you can go over the building there and save quite some time.
Okay, not fun. Not fun.
This right here is probably the most annoying part of the game, and the most boring one. Why is that? Pretty simple. This whole section, let's say the next two splits, are completely on a timer. This right here, oh come on, will always take 2 minutes and 15 seconds, and the second part will always take exactly 6 minutes 30. I know, I don't think it's exactly 6:30, but pretty much.
Is gone. Here is all it is, and it is the integrity's vital task.
So on a marathon, this would be donation time. Oh, by the way, second time that I have to stack crates during downtime, luckily, because right there you saw how wonky it is to do so.
I don't belong there, and I don't belong here either.
That is a little bit story of this guy saying that we shouldn't be here. We should go back to our game. And Athena obviously is like, it's not my game. I'm from the real world. And yeah, he tells us that the real world doesn't exist anymore.
Maybe it's the cyber goth look you're rocking.
Which, little spoiler, is not true. Oh, well, it's kind of true for us. Well, we'll get to that later. So, let's read something here. Don't mess with well. Well, we are going to mess with this well right here. Actually, I've never read that. Why not? Wow, so much action! Using a valve and then going down here. Having separate splits for two parts of this section is kind of dumb, actually, but I just get used to it. Oh, come on.
Can anybody hear me?
So the rumors are true. Somebody else made it here from the old world.
Who is this? Where am I?
This place is unreal, isn't it? Yeah, actually it's death and glory, but unreal is in here too. We're in a whole universe of games, so don't ask me how we got here.
I think the more prominent question is how do we get out? I heard someone say
this was what I was talking about in the very beginning, by the way. In the mid game, weapons we get are really bad. The enemies right here are actually weaker than the cyborgs we fought in the end of the first part of the game. But you are expected to not have enough ammo from the first world, so you have to use this mid-game weapons here, which really are shit. This is another one. It's a shotgun, but it's way worse than the one we already had. Oh, and by the way, we are in the cover shooter section, so the right click of every weapon we get here is iron sight. Every single one has iron sight. Okay, that's not exactly iron sight, but it's similar.
I was pretty tasty. As a girl, I had to be twice as good to get half the respect.
This is as far as we can go right now. Now we have to wait for dialogue. Kill some zombies in the meantime, because why not? Oh wait, that's the wrong weapon. I don't want to use that one. I want to get rid of this one here, because it's just in the way. Maybe it's time to talk about unskippable dialogue again. It is unskippable, that's true. It is possible to speed it up though, but we chose to not allow this, because how it works, at least how it works for me, is if I tap out of the game right now and then tap back in, the current dialogue would still be playing, but the next line would also start immediately. It's not a nice thing to hear, having all the lines of dialogue at the same time. And also, apparently it doesn't work like this for everyone. At least from one of the other runners of this game, I know that his game crashes as soon as he taps out.
But what about this corruption?
The corruption's a bogeyman integrity dreamt up to scare everyone into obedience.
Why are they still coming? That's unusual.
Why?
Oh, come on. Leave me alone. I need to get through here. Really low right now, but it's not a big issue. This here is also on a timer. We just have to survive for 3 minutes straight. You don't have to kill a single zombie here. I'm still gonna do so, because if there's too many of them, that might create lag. But the main reason actually is boredom. If this was possible to speed up somehow, that would be so great for the speedrun. But I honestly don't think it is possible. Just by the way, how this game is programmed. Generally, it's not programmed too well, I have to say. But it works as the programmer wanted it to most of the time. Because he's working a lot with triggers that are not too big, so he's like expecting you to reach an exact point. And because of that, he also worked with a lot of invisible walls, which I really don't like. Both generally and especially for the speedrun. We could do so much cool stuff, but nope, invisible walls. So another good minute to go until this glitch there will open and we can leave. Meanwhile, I collected some ammo. I'm using only the mid-game weapons to kill those guys because I wouldn't use that in any other situation anyways. Let me get up one more time to get the zombies up so that they don't disturb me when I want to leave. I didn't kill too many of them this time, so we actually experienced a little bit of lag. And now this is where we get the most important weapon in this game, both categories. In New Game Plus, this is basically the only thing you see. What I did right there was quick saving and quick loading. The reason for that is when you save and reload, you will have the world, let's call it the world will be saved. And your position, enemies, nearly everything. An exception, however, are weapons. Weapon pickups will not be saved. So I just quick saved and quick load to get the sticky bomb launcher a second time, just to have some more ammo to use. So right now we're playing through Pac-Man. There was a ghost there, but he left, luckily. So what you're supposed to do is collect all the thingies here. Then you can leave via glitch. What? I didn't even see him. Should focus a little bit more. So if you get hit, you take some damage and you're teleported back to your starting position. I have some spare rockets that I can use to dodge these guys. And would probably be the best idea to look up all the time and use this kind of map on the ceiling. But for some reason I then start missing those points. I don't know how I do it, but I somehow do it. Even though this section is a little bit boring to watch, maybe it is kind of exciting to play, because those little fuckers always surprise me. So I skipped this, and the glitch opened, so we can leave. And it was pretty fast, actually. Nice. I tried something there, it didn't work. So classic arcade games continue with Space Invaders. And I'm trying to kill them as quick as possible. This can get really annoying, but it wasn't too bad. And now there's this guy to kill the next boss. I'm gonna use minigun again, because as said, it has the most DPS of all the weapons in the game. keep swapping weapons to reload fast, and it should be dead pretty soon. I'm trying to not get too close, because then you're gonna get thrown away. That was okay.
We're falling back to Galastria. Integrity are overwhelming Liberty City. I'll see you there.
That is the next glitch
I'm
world.
Feeling too.
We can you're skip a little bit of it. And I was so busy talking, I nearly fell down.
Thousands of them. And those little fuckers are evil, man. Don't be fooled.
Hello? Anybody out there hearing this?
I'm gonna quick save here because for some reason I tend to mess this up, even though there is basically nothing to mess up. But I don't know.
It was what all the dickwads said whenever they found out a girl had hopped onto their server. So I thought, fuck you, I'm Buzzkill.
Maybe talking about the route in general a bit. Route in this game was interesting. The actual paths where you have to go, that's easy to do, no problem at all. But finding out where to get ammo for the sticky bomb launcher, where to use it to get the most out of the limited ammo you have, and so on, that took quite some time. And I was really surprised how well that turned out, especially the last levels. Because for the last levels, you have exactly enough to skip everything you want to skip. So it continues with games that are not really FPS.
I'm on my way. Take someone's eye for this.
We had to get this sword in order to advance, because up there there's a locked door. It's there's eyes around it, and you need this sword to get rid of the eyes. You can also use it to boost around a little bit. Oh, that was good as well.
Flee while you can, for they have summoned abominations from another realm.
Okay, that was pretty good. And that should have been quicker, but it's fine.
Fuck not face huggers.
I was about to say something before I failed and lost concentration. Don't remember what it was. Whatever. Ah, I think, yeah, it was about the skip I did. This is one of the levels that could be skipped so easily, especially in New Game Plus. You could skip everything. Oh yeah, that was what I was talking about earlier. Oh, damn it! If I mess up my routing a little, then I will pick up the weapon. That's the one we would have also gotten in the very first glitch. Crossbow. Not really useful though. That was still faster than expected. Accepted. What am I saying? How much do I have left? Yeah, I can use it here. It has been a couple days since I did a run of this.
I suppose I should be grateful I didn't find myself in a leopard skin loincloth, a push-up bra, or some
it's
character
really
design
going good.
Wankover.
Athena, you make it out of Calastria in one piece? I heard the integrity hit it hard.
Yes, I got out. Where are you?
On a transit through Quake 4. Normally I hate rail sections, but it's the quickest route to the glitch that'll take me to Planet Fire.
So, as can be seen again, this is a this level's completely open. You could, with enough ammo, boost all the way to the end.
Jesus.
But I only have 3 shots to spend in this level, and now this is gonna get dangerous. Oh no, did I go too far? No, but I still think I shouldn't have done it this way. That's fine. Basically, what is going on here? You know what? On second thoughts, let me tell you what happened right now, because this is a little scary. Did I reload? Yeah, I reloaded. And oh yes, I'm stupid. That's what I am. I wasn't full ammo. So what happens there? Usually you have to wait in the air until you're released. But if you boost yourself in the air, that can move you, but you're still unable to move the normal way. So what I did, I was boosting as far as possible with my limited ammo and having to reload, until the dialogue ended where you are put down finally, and then I quick saved and quick loaded, and then I could move normally again. Also, I used the quick save, quick load thingy again to get more ammo in. Alright, I made it. As said, you have to use a very specific amount of ammo every time you boost. Now we are heading to the worst level probably in the speedrun. Why is it the worst level? Because it's very inconsistent. I'm gonna submit this with the estimated of 1 hour 15 probably, even though if this level does not completely screw up, you are done within an hour. But there's quite some stuff that can happen. In the end, you're supposed to fight off some wave of enemies. And some of them are new enemies. You just saw one of them running away in the very beginning. They can turn nearly invisible. There's still a slight purple shimmer. There you can see it. You can see him, but it's hard. And they can also glitch out. I don't exactly know when it happens, but it is really bad if it does. Because then, gotta concentrate for a second here. Because what happens then is they will just stand around nearly invisible, and I'm required to kill every single one of them. So it's basically searching for the last enemy, which is really not cool. But this is a thing that's not too bad. This is a thing you can handle. What can also happen is that one enemy, no matter if one of the invisible guys or the normal red ones, they can just wander off. They are supposed to charge you, but well, they didn't find you. They're just going somewhere on this map, and you can't even tell which the enemies you're supposed to kill are, and which are the ones that are there from the very beginning that you can leave alive. So that's a reset, or not a complete reset in a marathon, of course, but I would still have to restart the level. So right, oh yeah, I missed the spawns already. That's not good. Come on, shoot. This level is also why I love this weapon. It's very important here. Because on easy, the sniper rifle still kills enemies on hit when you hit the body. That's pretty cool. On harder difficulties, it wouldn't, but on easy it does. I also got another sniper rifle, this one there, and they both one-hit enemies. That's... without those weapons, it would take much longer. When I smoke around, the nearly invisible guys are actually easier to see. Oh, come on.
Fight.
But yeah, you could see him there. This slight purple shimmer. Ah, that was only the land that blocked me. For a second I thought that might have been an enemy. Come on, get visible. He's somewhere up there. He'll come down eventually. This level is really not fun in the end. You have to wait for spawns, you have to hope that nothing is glitching out, you have to... just not nice. Also, my ammo for this weapon, as I already said, is perfectly routed. So I get into this final fight with 3 ammo left, and there are 2 of the sticky bomb launchers for me to pick up. Each of them gives me 3 ammo, so I'm now back at 21, which is the maximum, and also exactly the required amount. It's really hard to see them on a longer range. It's going rather slow here. But I'm actually fine with it. As long as I don't encounter any of the glitches, for this run I'm perfectly fine. Was he there or was he behind me? There's still quite some enemies to kill. Yeah, right now they will spawn a lot of those guys. I really want to use this weapon to kill them. It is easier to use the shotgun, but I don't know it for sure, but I think if you hit another enemy by accident with a shotgun while he's not really on screen, that's what can cause them to glitch out. I'm really not sure, it's just a theory. But I haven't had this problem, luckily, since I stopped using shotguns in this level. So I'm definitely losing time now. It was obvious that I'm going rather slow right now. Also important, don't die. Alright, that was it. No glitches encountered, so that's fine. Still lost a lot of time, so it's not gonna be a record, probably. Actually, it could still be, I guess. Yeah, it could still be, and my PBN messed up the last level. and got a little unlucky in this one, I think. There's a little bit of RNG coming up. But first, some more downtime.
Maybe a friendly word of advice to help you out.
It's not possible in new game, but in new game plus you can boost up to the ceiling and then look around. I actually could. I don't know, I'm not getting high enough, am I? Yeah, that's where we're gonna go. So as it can be seen, this game is really not programmed too well. But it works because they just put invisible walls everywhere, which is really sad. South is when we're leaving. Yeah, by the way, about the story. There was a guy called Bedlam talking a lot to us, giving tips to us.
Head for the sky platform. I've taken back the spawn points, but
I think like this. Okay, nice. I need to reload this, or I will forget it.
Yes, I found some serious malware.
Okay, now I need a little luck. We need to hit a gunship, and need to appear somewhere here. Otherwise, I can't hit it. Yeah. Also, it sucks to hit this thing. Luckily, you have the quick save, quick load thing. So that was really, really good RNG.
No time to get into that.
Getting it this fast.
We can't. They've closed the glitches.
So I was talking about story. So there was a guy, Bedlam, helping us, giving us a lot of hints and stuff. But it turned out it was just the integrity trying to trick us and.
Okay.
Yeah, the integrity wants to delete us, every other real person trapped in this world. And one of them is also the real Bedlam, who's with us now.
And would you mind letting me in on where we're actually headed?
Where do you think? Integrity Central, the Citadel.
Bedlam, actually, this game's based on, or not really based on, it's the sequel to a book.
Why are they erasing game worlds?
As far as I know, I think it was a sequel. So the book is about Ross Baker, aka Bedlam, the real Bedlam. And yeah, this is kind of the same world. Nothing really to say about this here. It's a fun little gimmick. I don't really like this level, and it's actually, it doesn't matter what you do. I try to play the level a little bit though, because if you die here every single time, that gets annoying. But I think I will take time to drink something real quick.
Does that mean Buzzkill and others have been extracted?
Not yet. There's still time.
I'm pretty happy, by the way, that it doesn't matter what you do here. It will always have the same time, and it's really good because I'm incredibly bad at this. So if you had to be good at this for the speedrun, that would be.
Yeah. I remember you telling me you used to be a pretty good gamer.
I couldn't even try to go for any records. I'm just so bad.
Looks like I was right.
But luckily, that's not the case.
We're getting close now.
Wait a sec. Just to recap, the two of us, just the two of us, are heading for a massively fortified enemy base to take on an entire army of ludicrously tooled up bampots.
Yep. Doesn't that sound like a classic FPS?
No. It sounds like suicide.
Ah, it's not. See, I packed for this trip. You've heard of the originals, right? The first scans had certain abilities that we disabled in subsequent builds, but when I uploaded myself, I altered a few protocols.
You're telling me you've got superpowers?
Better than that, I'm telling you I've got admin privileges. With your help, you can kick all the fun-ruining wankers off this server.
So what's the plan? How do we play this?
By the way, about my times, yeah, you've seen, I did a lot of best segment times. And you might have already guessed, none of us speedruns this game for too long. I really wanna get this done perfectly, so I'm gonna focus real quick. Did I shoot one off? I hope not. Whoa, I think I shot more than one off. So yeah, until ESA, there might be more or less changes about this run. Oh my god, yeah. That's exactly what I did on my PB as well. Don't switch too often. Yeah, finally. That was one of the wonders, in my opinion, how you can get up exactly with the ammo you have. Actually, that's not exactly true. Might need one less, but... By the way, it's really important that I don't put this weapon away right now. Because if I put it away with zero ammunition, I'm gonna lose it. And just listen to a dialogue and you will understand why I need to have this weapon, even if it has no ammo.
Seriously, if he throws any more licensed characters at me, any luck the lawyers will shut him down before you do.
Should I ask why you were using a rubber dildo?
I was out of ammo.
You said you had admin privileges.
So? Of course! Unlimited ammo!
Bam! Unlimited ammo.
Take it forward mode if you're hacked too far.
And... Oh, that was really bad. Holy crap. That was incredibly bad and I don't really know where I am. You can get... Oh, I'm not far away. Okay, that's not good, but fine, I guess. This is where I wanted to go, and it's perfectly doable.
Okay.
You have to hit the trigger here. This boss usually can only be harmed when using one of these jump pads you see right there. Because that would be really slow to do it the intended way, I just placed a lot of sticky bombs on him and then detonated them when being airborne. But because of the jump pad, so I could basically one hit him. Yeah, so these are the credits. Run is done. I hope you enjoyed. I hope this will get in. I think I'm gonna also submit New Game Plus, but little hint, I really prefer this one. This, in my opinion, is way cooler. But I'd be fine to run anything. I'd be happy to run anything. So, yeah, hope you enjoy. See you on further submissions.